Check out, but definitely both players here have some sort of item play. I did not expect the banana to bounce off the gyro. But, I feel like if anyone might have an advantage here, it's probably going to be, Rob Gyro here, at least in terms of, I guess, banana. Because one of them plays neutral, one of them plays not neutral. Right now, though, looking a bit tough for Straw Hat Zelda. He's already got a big deficit he's trying to overcome here. It's kind of what the map is going to shade. You guys like really good, like, gyro play, so it's, like, kind of hard to play around it. Oh, what? Holy shit, he went for down throw. Next thing you know, Shane will have his 0 to death combos left over the summer. Probably won't, actually. He never uses those. But if he did side B off stage, that would be very crazy. At least for Shane's standards. Right now, though, these two kind of just fighting over the gyro. I feel like Shane does like a lot of like C drop stuff with the gyro. He's definitely like using it a lot in his game. Like, I feel like. He plays like a very like he likes to wait out a lot and he like jumps around and moves around trying to select it for that overhead. But I think as Rob it's kind of more difficult to do that just because you know Rob being and reliable game. I think instead Shane's gameplay when he plays Rob is more of like a to get gyro out and then use that as a way to try and force your opponent to approach you.
Yeah, definitely. That's why I think Rob ends up succeeding so well. Is just throw out those things, press those buttons, and you don't have to
respect anything your opponent does.
To an extent, it's fun.
Wow.
And that seems to be the best now.
I think it's kind of one of the reasons why Shane's gameplay is also one of the things you gotta worry about against Rob. He has like a lot of ways to mix up his recovery and the punish and stuff like that. It'd be really, really scary.
Despite all that, it seems like that makes me I think Rob has the more cheese factor, but honestly, no, I don't know.
Yeah, the damage.
Never underestimate Diddy.
I don't know how I feel about that. I guess it was worth going for, but
yeah, I think it was just
like I don't know. I feel like Rob is someone who's recovering always have to like give at least a decent amount of respect to how he can mix it up and be a bit tricky with it. So it's like kind of hard to say you know you should just try and go for it when you can just try and reverse it really easily.
Yeah.
This is a close game though. Oh no. I thought that might have been cursed there. Got a parry, but no punish. Oh, this could be a bit tricky. It's an up air. Oh, that's the stock.
Lost the mini game.
I don't know if he was.
Oh, yeah, I think I was
dead. How much rage Rob had?
I've seen people live Rob that player at ridiculous percents that I haven't seen possible, and I still want to know their secrets. Like, I don't know how Shane
Let's
can
update the score here. Shane got a pretty uneasy run to get that. So I will see if
Yeah, definitely. Rahat Zelda can Rahat Zelda out for sure. definitely want to try. I think he could definitely take this. I mean, it's looking really competitive, but I think the main thing here is you gotta watch out.
I like the enemy unit just because, I think this is gonna go on.
Do you think?
I feel like I don't actually like this enemy.
Yeah, I was like,
well,
I think
the platforms are not bad, because I feel like it wasn't. I feel like especially against Rob, he's gonna be looking for stuff like those falling like bears on you. So I feel like having those platforms sometimes can definitely be helpful. And I feel like, especially with how Shane has been playing, he's been playing very horizontal. So I feel like having those, like, especially with those gyros, right? Like, I feel like whenever you see him use the gyro, it's always like, oh, it's either in the direction of Diddy Kong or he's, like, shooting it out for the first time.
Yeah.
And I feel like, even though I kind of understand maybe it's a comfort pick, but I feel like with the way Shane plays, I don't like this pick. Because I feel like it really just gives gyro a lot more power over the game. Yeah, I'm very surprised about that one. I don't know if it was just a timing thing or if he just had a good spacing on it.
Yeah, I think it just seems.
Yeah, trying to just find some sort of way in on Shane. Obviously, Star has Zelda had a huge lead because he got the stock really early in the first stock, but unfortunately, he hasn't been able to capitalize ever since, which is, I think, a really good aspect. So if Straw has other wants to get this tier, I think you A have to hold on to the stock and make Shay work for it. Yeah, that's true. I feel like
trying to get out of the
corner. I mean, I think that's good now, but I feel like especially when the percents get higher, it's gonna be a bit more risky to go
for
it.
That's why
if Shane calls one of them out on you, this could be like
that's
sweat handshake. That was a risky. I don't know how to think about that. He didn't get punished for it, but honestly, if Shane was more aware, he could have just gone for like a down there and back. I think it's been good though that he's going for the Donkey Plus mix up when he recognizes the gyro's up ledge, because it's really hard to get off. Okay, this could be.
Oh,
well, I don't think there was any barrier.
Yeah.
Those were us. Nice. That was a bit. Oh, backflip. I definitely tried to do it.
It's definitely.
Oh, man. That was a really good gyro from Shane, though. Wow.
That was crazy.
That was a really
good one.
Wow. I'm pretty surprised that worked.
Straw Hat Zelda managing to clutch it up out of the skin of his teeth, quite literally. Bro was probably milliseconds away from getting a drop down smash to the end of the game.
Yeah, for sure.
So, I don't know what stage they picked. I think it was Smash Bros. Or Hollow Bastion.
Yeah,
right.
Hollow Bastion.
Alright, that makes sense. I feel like Hollow Bastion does make sense, though, because I think with the way she's playing, it's more zony. Kind of trying to invent the. Kind of make it so strong as it is. Like those layers and stuff.
Yeah.
So previously, definitely make it a lot easier. Right now, though, Straw has all the. Deficit. 70 already on him. That's how it's believable, but goddamn, I can't believe that. And this is kind of what I was afraid of, at least with this pick for Strahzelda. Shane's kind of game plan seems to revolve around using those gyro. And while it feels like it would be a good idea to have a platform, I feel like just having it at mid stage is not that great. Just because Shane's not really running the stage.
That's fun. There's also, I think, a lot less space where Pokemon's look like me as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think it goes both ways. Like, I think, on one hand, yeah, it's true that zoners typically aren't that, like,
Game 1.